डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द स्टैंडर्ड 6 सोशल साइंस क्लास. डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू पार्ट 3 सिविक्स चैप्टर 5. ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन पेज नंबर 240. पंचायती राज. चिल्ड्रन, वी ऑलरेडी रीड द विलेज इज द बेसिक यूनिट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सिंस एंशिएंट टाइम्स. In this chapter, we will learn what is Panchayati Raj, what are the different levels of Panchayati Raj, and what is the role of Panchayati Raj. So, let's begin the chapter. India is a large country. It is not possible for the central government to look after all the matters and fulfill all the needs of every citizen. To make the administration easier and smooth, the government of India works at 3 levels, the central, the state and the local. So first of all, we will see central government. Central government is seated in the capital city of New Delhi. It deals with the matters of national importance. State government, each state has its own government. It maintains law and order, local transport, health services, etc. Local government, it looks after the local needs of a city, town or village. Next we will move on. What is local government? A local government is an institution which is constituted to look into local problems and to provide bare amenities to people of a village, town or city. Importance of local government. Number one, local people are more familiar with their local problems, so their solutions are more practical and realistic. Point two, the local people can get their work done better, quicker and cheaper at the local level. Point three, the participation of local people in the local government generates the spirit of cooperation. Point 4. It reduces the workload of the state and central government. Point 5. The local government provides sufficient scopes to acquire training and experience in administration to the elected representatives of the local government. Point 6. The village community participates more actively in development measures since it is for its own benefit. So now we will see Panchayati Raj. What is Panchayati Raj? The system of local government at village is known as the Panchayati Raj. The Panchayati Raj is a system of self-government in rural areas. It aims at rural development by involving the rural community. It strengthens the foundations of Indian democracy. Children, what is Panchayat? Panchayat literally means a committee or 5 village people. In our country, the system of Panchayat is very old. Every village had a Panchayat which consisted of 5 elders of the village. These elders solved all the problems in the village. The decision was binding on all. This system functioned well till the Mughal period. It was discontinued during British rule. After independence, Panchayati system once again gained importance. So, next we will discuss Panchayati Raj. The three-tiered system. The Panchayati Raj system is a three-tiered system suggested by the Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. It aims at the promoting a form of self-government among the villages of India. Constitutional status was provided to the Panchayati Raj institutions through the 73rd Amendment Act of 1993. It works on their levels at village, block and zilla level. The highest level is the district or Zilla Parishad. The district is divided into blocks called the Block Samiti or the Panchayati Samiti and the lowest level is the village panchayat. All the three institutions together look after the needs and problems of the rural area, and they are together called the panchayati raj. The panchayati raj system at village level consists of three main bodies: gram sabha, gram panchayat, and nyaya panchayat. So first of all, we'll discuss gram sabha. What is gram sabha? The gram sabha is the lowest unit of the panchayati raj at village level. The gram sabha is a meeting of all adults who live in the area covered by a panchayat. See children, a gram sabha picture. The gram sabha consists of men and women in a village who are 18 years of age and above. They meet twice a year. The size of the gram sabha differs according to the population of the village. Next, we'll see functions of the gram sabha. There are 6 points. Point 1, all problems of the village are discussed by the gram sabha. Point 2, it elects the gram panchayat. Point 3, it passes the annual budget. Point 4, the gram sabha evaluates the work and the accounts of income and expenditure of the gram panchayat. Point 5, it acts as the Lok Sabha in the center and legislative assembly in the state. It acts as a check on the powers of the gram panchayat and has the power to remove any of its members if his work is unsatisfactory by means of a vote or no confidence. Point 6, the gram sabha prevents the panchayat from doing wrong things like misusing money or favoring certain people. Children, next, gram panchayat. What is gram panchayat? Gram panchayat is an elected body of villagers. It implements the decision taken by the gram sabha. Every panchayat is divided into smaller areas called wards. Each ward elects a representative who is known as the ward member or panch. The members of the gram sabha directly elect a... Children, turn the page. Elect a sarpanch who is the president of the panchayat. The gram panchayat also elects the deputy chairperson who officiates in the absence of the pradhan. The state election commission conducts these elections. There are seats reserved for members belonging to SC and ST. 50% of the total number of the seats are reserved for women. The gram panchayat is elected for 5 years. The gram panchayat has a secretary who is also the secretary of the gram sabha. This person is not an elected member but is appointed by the government. The secretary is responsible for calling the meeting of the gram sabha and gram panchayat and keeping a record of the proceedings. So children, now we'll see functions of gram panchayat. There are 7 points. Point 1, it works for the upliftment of the village and provides amenities like roads, drinking water and irrigation facilities. Point 2, it maintains birth and death records in the village. Point 3, it looks after the welfare of the people. It executes program of the state government. Point 4, living and collecting taxes and fees. Point 5, maintaining healthcare center and providing basic healthcare facilities to the people. Point 6, providing educational facilities, constructing and maintaining school buildings. Point 7, executing government schemes related to generating employment in the village. So children, these points you write down in the SST copy. The Gram Panchayat is answerable to Gram Sabha because its members are elected by the Gram Sabha. Children, the rest of this chapter we will discuss in my next video. Till then, thank you.